are in this grand scheme of things. True success lies in knowing who is the creator and who is the creation. And the very first verses that were revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us just that. Allah says, "Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq." The first verse to the final messenger, to the final ummah, Allah is saying who He is. And He is the one that created. And when we talk of His creation, my dear brothers and sisters, this creation of Allah is amazing. Because now, after hundreds and thousands of years of our science and our knowledge of science, we know that our scientists are telling us they are 1 multiplied by 10 to the 24th power of heavenly bodies, which means they are 1,24 zeros, a number way too big for us to call. In some, in British they call it the quadrillion. In America you call it the septillion. That's how many, it's like trillion, 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 trillion of heavenly bodies that are out there. And this is only the heavenly, the earthly heaven, or the sama'u dunya. Allah talks about the sama' samawat. He talks about the kursi. He talks about the arsh. About Allah, this is the creator. And then He tells the next verse, who are you and who am I? Khalaqa al-insana min 'alaq. When you look at this great, humongous creation of Allah, then who you are? He created you from a drop of clinging substance that you need microscope. You need every detail to see who you are. And you are nothing but a microscopic, so tiny. That's where we all began. And so if we know who we are, and we know who our Creator is, then we can know what success really means. And once we know who we are, and who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, then it leads us to know what is the Creator telling us about success, because you and I cannot determine that. When you plot us on a graph, we become a tiny dot lost in this universe. We become so tiny when we are put among this whole grand scheme of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us His grandeur and shows us who we are. So the second point is to know what the Creator wants from us. And first He tells us that if you believe in what He revealed, you're successful. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. They are the ones upon whom there is guidance, and they are the successful ones. Allah tells us that if we stay away from superstitions and heresies, that we will be successful. Allah tells us, being engaged in da'wah, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Allah is telling us that let there be from among you a nation, arise from among you, that will invite to what is good, forbid what is wrong, that these indeed are the successful people. The third way of success is surrendering to Allah. My dear brothers and sisters, this might look like an easy task, but surrendering to Allah is where many of our Muslim Ummah today is failing. Because surrender really means you do what Allah wants you to do without questioning why He wants you to do that. You and I cannot answer why Salatul Fajr is 2 rakat, Dhuhr is 4, Asr is 4, Maghrib is 3, Isha is 4. You and I cannot understand why some are recited loudly and some are recited silently. We do not know why you have to take just 7 tiny pebbles of the Jamarat when you overhatch. We surrender to Allah. And this is the process that Allah wants us to surrender. Like Mary, peace be upon her, when she was about to give birth, she was instructed, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُتَبًا جَنِيًّا. In that state of childbirth, she was still